Oh my word, what an interview with SK Vibemaker and DWE.
SK Vibemaker, Rinse FM, and we've got a very special guest in the building, not everyday conversations, a veteran, legend, icon, talk about many years in the game, man, influential, legacy. DWE's in the building, man.
Wagwan, my G.
Cheese. I mean, the album is finally wrapped up and ready for everybody to hear.
Right.
I mean, it's well overdue. Well overdue.
Trust me, my brother. Trust me, I know.
How does it feel to finally have the album done and sort of ready for everyone to hear?
Boy, man, it feels even better now because, to be honest, it's been done. And then it had to get, like, a few issues come up where I've had the finishing product, but there was still extra stuff to do that I had to put my heart into. And one of them things was artwork for physicals and making sure all my pages in my physical CD, I wanted to have a special message in there. So I was like, rah, I need a special message in there, like, to big up. This is my first album. Like, it's been a long time coming. I have to think about my journey to this point. Just writing that message alone there and just coming across other problems as well, where I even had to change two tracks on the album. Mm-hmm. And then one of the tracks was, I had to change two tracks basically. And so then I had to get that mixed and mastered, and now I've got that done. And then it was ready, and then we realised that on the artwork he's still got the tracks from before, so we had to get back to the artwork people to put the new two tracks on the artwork. Plus then I realised inside the booklet we're talking about the other two tracks that were there before, so we had to just all these things started unfolding.
Logistics.
And costing times, and this is when it's done. Mm-hmm. So it's like, now it's finally done. It's like, even when I get my first physical back from the CD chamber and I look at it, there could be a little mistake in there. And if there is, this is another set. So I've been trying to get past little hurdles. Mm-hmm. And it's the first time I'm going through this process, so it's like, well, when I come out with my next album, which I'm working on now, my second one, things will be a lot more snappy and I'll be a lot more aware of what to expect.
So you're fully in album mode now.
Album mode, making it.
This first album has like whetted the appetite.
Yes.
For you to realise, you know, I'm making albums now.
Yeah.
Like, when you look back, I'm sure you feel like maybe I should have put out an album a long time ago, or do you feel like the timing is right now?
I think a bit of both, man. I think the timing is right now, but I should have had an album out before.
Mm-hmm.
But I was looking for support, and looking for support is another setback.
Mm-hmm.
Because the support is within yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You have to have a finished product to get support.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get support without a finished product. You can't be in a man's face talking without no product.
Mm-hmm.
When the product's there,
then you can negotiate.
Then we can talk, innit?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm trying to, but obviously I'm aware of what I can do. This is why I thought support should be there in terms of pushing man forward, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But still, it doesn't matter how good you are, because there's some good people that just can't finish stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Then there's people that ain't good and they're just whipping up videos, they're just putting stuff together, they're making themselves, they're working.
Mm-hmm.
Working means a lot.
Work rate sometimes outdoes the talent.
It. Yeah,
you know
that
saying?
Is it. So I've got work rate, but this is a different sort of work rate. This ain't just picking up the mic and spitting and being ready to spit. There's bear guys with that work rate. But work rate within developing finished products, it's a different work. It's a different thing.
Well, listen, man, we got things to talk about. We're going to play some music right now. We're going to play Nang featuring Skepta. Just introduce this for us.
Right. This one's Nang featuring Skepta, produced by Footsie. mad thing.
Oh my word, what an interview with SK Vibemaker and DWE.
I'm waiting. Yeah. Me and the beat go hand in hand. Salmon down with the mic in hand. Game of cards, got the best hand. The hand as soon as I land. You can't tell me back. Can't dip on the microphone, dip on the microphone, dip on the microphone. Dip on the microphone.
SK Vibemaker, Rinse FM, and I got a legend in the building. No introductions needed. I don't use these words lightly. This is a guy that just is very humble. DWE in the building, man.
Yeah, man, Medea, live.
The Jackham album's ready for everyone to hear. You're going to hear it very, very soon.
August, man, August.
August times.
Yeah, it's coming out in August. So 100% August. Mm-hmm. And yeah, boom, I'm excited right now.
So we just played Nang featuring Skepta. Not talking a wedding, but I'm the best man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. For you to feel confident, like, I look into the eyes of a lot of artists, MCs that have been out here for a long time, and they talk about, you know, being the best and all this kind of stuff. But when I look in their eyes, I can see that they don't believe it. But you are an artist that is very respected, you know, respected by your peers, the newer generation, the olders. Like, how would you explain the position that you're in at the moment? How does it feel to be DWE right now?
Boy, it feels good to be being myself, and because I feel like things are being made harder for me, and I feel like I'm a man that loves to work.
Mm-hmm.
So because I work hard. And I always put my best in. There's no difference between competition and playing.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, and another thing is I don't really watch other people.
Mm.
And this helps the heart, do you get me? Because when you're watching other people, they can affect you.
Mm.
And I watch people, but I watch people from a different aspect.
Mm-hmm.
And that's, this is it. But the way some people look at the game, I never looked at the game as competition.
Mm.
I just looked at the game as everyone having fun.
Mm. And maybe but, elements of inspiration as well.
Yeah, now it's different. Now people are, but what it is, you just gotta have your chance and do your best at your chance. But people, another person's chance can affect people and make people think it's unfair. Everything's fair. It's all fair. Like, what are you talking about? Mad thing.
That's real talk, man.
Yeah.
Over 15 years in the game. Like, I mean, a lot of consistency. Been out here relevant for a long time. Yeah. And I know I've asked you this a few times in interviews, but I feel like I need to ask you again. How do you maintain the hunger? You know, right now, like, sort of being so many years deep in the game and still energized, motivated and hungry to put out an album, to put out new music, to keep going. Where do you summon
because,
that from?
Because for me, it's not enough. It's not enough. Like, if you're telling me all these things I've achieved, but it's not enough. It's never enough. It's never enough.
Mm.
We always want more. I want more. I want to be able to be able to show you many things, all because of who I am. I don't want you to just tell me who I am and I'm just here and I've got to be blessed. I've got to be able to show you stuff, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You've got to be able to present stuff in the end of life. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? So me, I'm never happy, and anyone that's making money and you're making a certain amount of money, you always want more. You made 1 million and now you thought, well, I want two, and now you got two, now you want three.
Mm-hmm.
And this is it. So for me, I'm not happy,
and that's what's driving you.
Yeah, to drive to yeah, and to tick things off of the list. I'm still working, and I'm working the way I want to work to achieve it. I'm not desperate, getting on my knees to try and, I'm going to do it my way, and I believe in myself.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it.
And that's an important factor. You know, there's been a close circle of people that have heard your debut album, Jackham. Some people have heard it in its entirety. Some people have heard bits. It hasn't been released yet. It's about to be released. You know, tell people what they can expect from the album? Is there any curveballs on there? I know maybe people expect some D&B, some drum and bass on there. Is there any dancehall, any hip hop? Is there any house? Is it majority grime?
I don't know how to explain it. I would say that you can get all them vibes from it, but it's not actually that. So it's fresh. It's a part of me that I've never been able to show the people, because when I show the people my music in Jibs and Drabs, and then I got this tune, and then I got Bad to the Bone, and then I got Like This, produced by Champion over there, then I got Gorgon City over there. When I'm giving you me as D Double, as a piece, as a sound, you don't know what's coming. No one really knows my sound. So when you hear it, this is gonna be, it's like, it's new.
Was there something that you was very clear that you wanted to get across as a sound? Was there a consistent sound that you wanted to be?
Nah, there wasn't a consistent sound. It's just music, man. I would just say music. I'm very musical. Even though, like, when I hear Wiley Godfather album, it's like it's I was aware that, raw, this is real grime. This is grime. It's like it was bringing that sound. I could listen to it as a whole and say, raw, this is that. So this is what I'm bringing to the table. What I'm bringing is different from that. So you'd say, is it all grime? But to me, that's grime. And my album, it's not like that, but it's in a different field of the same thing. It's like a vision, you know what I'm saying? I don't know, man, it's mad.
They're gonna hear Jackham soon. We're gonna play more music. Your track with Gorgon City, hear that. Just introduce this for us.
Yeah, this one, D-double-E, hear that. Gorgon City on production, mad thing.
Oh my word, what an interview with SK Vibemaker and D-double-E.
SK Vibemaker, Rinse FM, D-double-E in the building. What are we saying?
Bloco.
We just played your collaboration with Gorgon City. Hear that? If I can't put food in the fridge, I don't want to hear that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's a big talk.
Yeah, bruv, man. You know, like, that one there, that was a mad concept still. And the way I put them bars on that beat, I was thinking, raw, like, this is like a big man thing. Like, what I'm saying is mad. Like, I was even thinking, I phoned them, man, and I was like, you know what? I feel like I need to just do like a clubby sort of, like, less party vibe, because what I'm saying on here is mad stuff. I felt like I needed a different beat, a bit more of a deeper beat. You know what I'm saying? Not house, but what I was saying was firm. You get me? Then I was like, nah, man, you can skank the wheels. I was like, nah.
So you,
man,
felt,
nah,
like the content and the concept was maybe a bit too, like, deep for that, yeah, sort of playful,
right,
production.
But then it ended up working. It's like, it's because that's how we're meant to be looking at these things. You're meant to be thinking that and actually smiling about it. Like, yeah, man, don't want it. Like, it's not the thing. You see, but it's not really serious where we need to, like, where all a bit more angry, and you know what I mean? It's a bit more. So I like the way it's turned out.
Talk to us about connecting with Gorgon City then, because, you know, this is one of the lead singles off their album.
Yeah, them man hollered at me a little while ago still. I'd say I've been chatting to them for maybe just over a year now. And then, yeah, we got in the studio, done a few different tracks, but this one was standing out. And I weren't happy at first, and I was telling them I wanted to change the bars, and then all of a sudden they sent me this new mix, which is the one we're hearing today.
And it all made sense.
This was like, this is a banger.
I know you kind of, you know, queried the production, you've made sort of, this is a housey type of vibe. Yeah. You've done things like this before with like Rhythm Commission and stuff. Is this a kind of sound that you're going to be sort of exploring more? Can any of this be expected on the Jackham album?
No, this is not Jackham. Jackham, that DEE Jackham, that life there is like really, 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 it's like, yeah, it's the next thing. But all these vibes, like, they're UK vibes, and that's what I'm on. I'm on UK. Anything to do with the UK, I'm on it. It can be drum and bass, boom, boom, boom. But that's not my album. That's not going to be the album. The album is going to be more the platform I've launched myself in as DEE today. So it's going to be more closer to that. But I have fun on funky house shows. If Danao called me, and told me, yeah, I'd merc that. I'd merc it. I'm a UK mercus. But you can't call me on no beats where I got to sound like I'm doing some next thing.
No drill beats.
No, chill is UK. Chill's UK. All day long, but I'm not doing anything else what's not the thing.
So you've set up Local Music, your own label, your own imprint. How's it been being a label head, a label boss, calling the shots?
Man, it's been my best life ever, bruv.
Really?
It's been my best life ever. And my album, Jackham, is the birth of it. And it feels like I'm starting again. So when DEE met anyone, I was already DEE. Yeah, when I met Nasty Crew, I was already DEE murking. And that DEE there never had no one telling him nothing. When I was just in my room doing my thing. When I met guys, this is when guys saw the power. No one helped my power come. The power was there. So when people were telling me what to do and giving me advice, this is me getting further from the guy you met. See what I'm saying? Right now, my vision is so clear and it's pure, and pure is what makes it.
Do you feel like there was a time when, you know, people were trying to sort of get involved and, you know, put their hands in the cauldron and maybe sort of make you veer off and do different things or advise you? Was that a period?
I would just say I wasn't really going with what I wanted to do. I was kind of like just on anything. On anything that's half all right. Everything, every penny counts. I'll do that one. Yeah, I'll do that one. It all counts, but It's when I'm doing my stuff, when I like tunes like Lovely Jubbly, that's me, that was me. I picked the beat, just the beat, that was me. Like Nang, that was me. See, Hard is a banger. That weren't me though. See what I'm saying? That was Footsie. This is where the respect comes in. When a man brings me something with levels, that's where it comes in. Footsie brought that to me, boom. So that's levels. But it's like, yeah, it's becoming more luck for these things. Like, but when I'm doing my thing, it's not luck.
Clear vision.
It's clear. It's just clear. Like, it's clear. Better than the rest. Like, I like that beat. That was me that picked that beat. I found the beat. When I'm finding my stuff, that's when you're going to see, like, raw, this beat's mad, raw. It's like when I'm doing my thing. So I'm just, my brain, back then, when you're hearing these beats, yeah, it's like, when you hear the production, you're going to hear, it's just far from a lot of stuff. It's far, but it's the same, but he's got his own angle.
It's mad that you've never sort of maybe veered into seriously making beats then. Has that ever been a thought then? Because of your eye and sort of the way that you're putting things together. Yeah. If you could produce as well, would be a madness.
I'm a sick producer, blood. I'm sick, but you know what? I'm sick, blood. I'm sick.
Of directing, about me, maybe, blood. Not sort of getting your hands dirty yourself then.
Yeah, even directing videos.
No, I mean sort of directing production.
Yeah, I'm on that. I've directed how many tunes on my album? I helped direct Lemon Trees. Lemon Trees is partly because of me. Back then, it's partly because of me. What other tunes? I've got other tunes on the album. One tune that Spyro and Diamonds made. Mm-hmm. They made it together on my album. And that track there, I was the one that steered where I wanted it to go. So that one's got this 80s, 90s vibe in it. Like, yeah. And I was the one that said, yeah, man, I want something like this. And then when I was with Swindle in LA and he made Lemon Trees and he was building a beat for me and the beat was all mad hard because people keep thinking D-double, then they're going in hard, making mad hard. I'm like, nah, man, we're in LA, bro. Let's do something like this. What? Okay, cool. Next thing you know, we got Lemon Trees, got Back Then. So I like to steer my vision. Even my music videos, they're partly my idea. Mm-hmm. So I told man, like, when I hear this tune, Nang, I just feel like it's a mosh pit. Mm-hmm. I just feel like drinks are flying in the air. It's just, I felt like there's a camera capturing it from above. So you're just looking at 50 people top of the head, but then we're just all going mad, throwing drinks, and then they got the vision, and then that's how Nang come.
Mm-hmm.
So I got a lot of the things on my album and to do with this is coming from me. This is what I like.
Mm-hmm.
And I've got two little TV programs that I'm building at the moment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see that. If anyone follows you on Insta, they will see that you got the little block of TV thing kind of running. So that's the beginning of the concept.
I got a concept. Come on, I'm going to need you as well.
I'm ready.
Definitely going to need you on there. And I'll talk to you about it after, but that's starting up. And yeah, I'm just putting my ideas, and before I wasn't doing this, I was more like, you tell me the idea. So my vision, I need to get moving into my world more.
You know, one of my favorite recent tracks of yours, Shenanigans. I like this one a lot, man. Let's play this, man. Introduce this for us.
Wait, this one, Shenanigans, produced by Swift the Beta. Marcus.
SK Vibemaker, Rinse FM. We got DEE in the building.
Yeah, man, Medea.
We just played Shenanigans. Now, we've been talking about a lot of legacy, a lot of history, you know, so far.
Yeah.
Over the last few years, there was kind of talk of a grime revival. And then it seems like over the last maybe year or so, that it's kind of changed a bit, like maybe with the power of Afro Swing, Afro Bashment.
Yeah.
So I don't know if we're still in the grime revival phase.
Yeah.
So what's your take on the current health status of the grime scene? How are you perceiving it at the moment?
Well, the status of the grime scene, I think it's healthy in certain areas. It's healthy, and in certain areas it's not. And in terms of entertainment and people wanting to go and have fun, there's things to do. But in terms of projects and movements, they're just small movements at the moment. Mm-hmm. Small. But yeah, man, I think it's all positive, man. It's positive for workers, man.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot of people trying to just jump on something, but it's not with full hands. It's more to do with a moment, mm-hmm. you know, like a moment.
Mm-hmm.
And no one's really trying to document stuff, man. No one's trying to document stuff. So yeah, that's the difference to me.
A few bandwagoners and stuff.
Yeah, it's just things are just, yeah, people are just fading in. I don't know what it is.
Trying to catch the vibes, a wave.
I grew up to R&B, ragga, hip hop. That was my surrounding counties.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't turn into ragga, R&B and hip hop in it. I didn't turn into them, man. So I don't know, somehow people were just turning into what we grew up in a generation of taking inspiration. Right now, the word inspiration is getting questionable, mm-hmm. in terms of, because when you're jacking, mm. and you're getting inspiration, it's two different things, mm-hmm. you see what I'm saying? So yeah, man, I like each place to have their thing in terms of their own look. Like when I look at Jamaica and look at America, and there's no way these two countries would be trying to look like us. Mm-hmm. No way. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're just that strong, and I'm that strong. So I'm saying, so I'm from that. So I'm not. It reminds me of a kid. A kid would wanna just sing every song, you know, like just be able to sing every song. But that's what it is, isn't it? Mm-hmm. A kid will be like, you can't. A kid is supposed to sing every different song. Mm-hmm. Supposed to. If a song, when I was a kid, I was singing all sorts of stuff. Mm-hmm. I was singing Count and I Joe and Where Did You Come From? Where Did You Go? This is on Top of the Pops, bro. I was singing mad stuff. But then you get into a thing where you start becoming yourself. You start thinking, okay, this is the school I go to. This is how we talk. This is what we do. Like, it never turns into, like, I don't know, man. There was only certain man that used to do that. Like, used to get a lot of like English reggae dons. Like, mm-hmm. man's blatantly from the ends, mm-hmm. but then when he's doing the music now, we just turn into the deepest Jamaican voice.
Mad.
That was, and then we had the American voice,
mm-hmm. the American accents.
Yeah, so then we had the American guy spitting with American accent. We didn't really rate that, man.
You know, the counter argument is funny, because I was only talking about this the other day, and I know it's slightly veering off, but why do singers get a pass? Because there are some singers that are celebrated nowadays, some of the greatest singers, without me mentioning names,
yeah.
and they definitely sing in a voice that is nowhere near to their talking voice.
When
it comes to MCs, it seems like they are critiqued in a different way,
yeah.
whether it comes to accents, whether it comes to cadence.
Yeah.
So it's mad, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think accents is the saviour right now. It's the saviour. So it doesn't matter what guys are copying, as long as the accent is you're sounding like where you're from,
yeah.
you can get away with murder. You're getting away with murder, you're getting away. So you can actually do the exact same song as a man, but just speak it in English. And then somehow you're just looking good. So guys have realized that the English accent is the thing.
Mm.
But it's still slipping away. You know, like if I just put on the radio now and then I put someone that's not really listening to the music and I say, oh, where do you think this guy's from? And I put it on now, it could be a myth.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see what I'm saying? It could be a myth. And then I'd have to tell you, nah. I'll say, all right, what country you think this guy's from? You start calling out bare countries. I say, nah, he's not. But this is where inspiration's going.
Mm-hmm.
See what I'm saying? So, I don't know. In my music, the way I've mixed all my inspirations in, you're going to get all them feelings from something new.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get me? So if you're winding down a girl, it doesn't have to be that beat to be winding down a girl. Yeah, but when you hear my thing, you're gonna be able to wind down a girl. See what I'm saying?
Let me ask you, what's been your favorite era so far?
Your
favorite era so far, man. There's been, you know, you've been out here and seen some changes. You know what I mean? From like, you know, doing the radio sets, phone ringing off.
I've enjoyed everything, man. I've enjoyed every era. Every era for me, every year.
Do you not miss the era like where you was doing radio sets, phone ringing off, raves and all that kind of stuff? Now it's more about, you know, the social networks, the likes, the maybe a man will just make a mixtape, but he's not maybe putting in the work.
You know what era I've missed? I've just missed the era of feeling like I'm surrounded by a movement of 100% UK dons.
Mm.
That's the era I miss. Mm-hmm. I miss the And the pinnacle of that era was when everyone was looking at us like we're coming with some different stuff. Yeah? This is when Dubstep got stolen. This is when Kanye, Drake first was aware of some sort of movement. Guys, that's not me. American guys are like, what? This is mad. It's like, duh. And then I could hear grime in productions and I could hear certain things. You know what I'm saying? I miss that was the pinnacle era of change, because what you're looking at is definitely nothing to, like, the culture. It was the culture. It was that culture that sucked everyone. The culture of that. The radio, you're telling me that this is the culture that when they was looking at it, they could probably see themselves in a different sense, not their self in, this is what I do. It's like what they do, but different. And I think a lot of ratings come from that, man. A lot of ratings and a lot of the support we're getting from guys, I don't believe it's new. I believe it's from them days into now. And they're just into it more now. You understand? But yeah, man, I think that was... And it's the beginning of now. It's the beginning of now. And that was... the day when we got people looking. So now it's like when I
cruise pirate radio, grimy stations.
When I used to get in my car, it used to be mad. Right now I can't even listen to radio, bruv. Back in the day it was just like, it was mad.
Listen, what we're about to do, we are about to flash back to the bars on this track right here have lived for so long. And if this gets played in the right place, in many places, it is an absolute pandemonium. Frontline. Just introduce this for us.
Right. This one, Frontline, yeah? Produced by Biggie D. Absolute Marcus.
Oh my word. What an interview with SK Vibemaker and DEE.
Check this. Think you're a big boy because you got a beard. Will make your face look weird. Draw for them, quickly disappeared. Left you there cause I ain't never cared. Into the car, slam it into the gears. For what had you done to get years? Heart is cold and I got no fears. Shed no tears, no MC compares. I've been batting up MC for years. From way back when they used to wear flares. By that time you opened your ears. I'm gonna climb to the top like stairs. Think you're a big boy, did you go gym? Cave your whole face in. Double to forget the swing. First you draw, will win. Don't come single against P-Double. You can try, but you won't be able. Soon gonna be signed to the label. Soon gonna see no on the table. Try mess with the door on the table. Open it, shake up your nostrils. Who's it? I might be double, not me single.
What is it?
Head get mangled, then dangled to the side just like I wear my kangoo. Nowadays I'm on arms just like a bangle. Try test me, get manhandled with a tool. I got, I like to mingle on road and especially in the dance hall. Try duck on the table or just from an angle. Now you wanna cancel cause you know you get rubbed out like pencil. You don't want me to make it look like a fool. Cause it's just that smoking menthol like it's commercial. When you wanna draw me blood, nah, that's cool. Only thing I'm gonna draw, better go home, make yourself useful before I'm new to you. What about no joking, live it cool. Easily turn routine typical. We jam my hand with a boom pool. Empty a dimple and temple.
Right there.
Who did you resemble? Face looks like my cool. I carry like it's legal. When the class gonna need more people. Bare people from the heavy like metal. So they got dope but they ain't got a shekel. See the big that looks like Ethel. Them MC better hide before I switch like Jekyll. Cool on cycle before I sting a ice kettle just like a metal before. Draw for the metal when they build back who there for. Don't start trouble with the double when I warmed up. I leave you in the living blood puddle. Greet you with arms, not talking it's to cover the doctor can't. Put you back together like a puzzle to hold your mouth shut like wearing a mother. Or your face will be wearing mine like a imprint to the side of your temple. You're the simple get got like a pimple. Sound of the D-double. E-double, not lead single. Who's with the mic riding the vinyl? Quick with it easy and simple. MCs get murked if they come out true with no rehearsal. You get a quick burial. Rinse them clean like aerial. Biological, that's in the more like cereal. Cause you mess with the new room general. And they take this music personal. We boys they don't take it personal. If you bring your crew and I murk them all. Right there on the spot like Clavisol. Cause I told you before, don't come single to get E-double. And put it up the nostril and pull. D-double E still whole. I'm part an article, still whole. I'm lyrically ill, still whole. Got lyrics to kill, still whole. Back in the day, Osha, still more time I got. Steady Louis, still whole. If lyrics are right, hey, still whole. Still whole. I single got a better one, still whole. Yo, D-double, spit, you feel, I keep it real. What's the deal? I heard you wanna steal my skill, you must know me still. I get the tune tapped like you by the chill, lyrical, now I'm muted, the DJ feel whole. Been that man back like the mingle, still whole. My selector know the deal. Keep shit real on the roof, just still whole. 16 bar, hot like tar, soon be a star, get ready far. Never gonna go away, permanent scar. Trust me, this lyric, no joke lyric. When I draw my lyric, make your new lyrics look very yo like no gold lyric. Make no dough lyric, can't match if you think you can. Then I draw for the next lyrics, lyrics. Better go and get next lyrics and make sure that they're your lyrics. There will never be a day when I'm speaking poor lyrics in war. Quickly draw 24 more lyrics. Speak like mad then in 4-4 lyrics. Hit you in the chest if you want the floor lyrics. Next time, never ignore raw lyrics. Like heavy rain, I pour raw, then I bust the next 16. Quick 16, gonna let off shots, no less than 16. Tearing MT to 16, bit 16, bit. Living the scene to bits from 16, and I'm still mean. 10 times better than when I was 16. Bare man could have checked when I was 16. Even man that was older than 16 didn't believe I was younger than 16. Now I'm ace 2-3. Sounded the double double part of the natural. Artistic sound touch it. You. That's the name of us. Trust we're gonna bust, cause we work hard enough. And enough new crews ain't hard enough to play with us. And they're hating us. We're not in the dash, so just move away. Cause if you mess with the new room general, mess with the new room general, get left in new room general. You get left in new room general. Mess with the new room general. Mess with the new room general. Get left in new room general. You get left in with the A and E.
Over and out. SK Vibemaker, Rinse FM 106.8 in London, streaming online and worldwide, www.rinse.fm. We've got DEE in the building.
Yeah, man, we're there, yeah.
A legend, an icon, a veteran, a massive legacy, a massive influence. I don't know if you thought when you started to get your status, early noughties, that you would be here now with such this reputation, because this isn't something that you can just, you know, you can't plot this, you can't sort of copy this. This is what a lot of guys would like to have. There are MCs, artists that have been out here, the duration that you've been out here, that have not had the impact, the consistency, the legacy. You know what I mean? So when you think about your impact right here, right now, when you started out, did you think that you'd be anywhere close to where you are now?
Nah, man. When I started out with... just for the fun, man. Like, really, just for the fun. Yeah. And I think that's the easiest way to kind of get the passion I have. If you're looking for money, girls, looks, fitting in, it can always go sideways.
Mm.
So.
For you, it was always about the art form.
Yeah, I was just always about, I separated money from music. Like, I need to make money, so I need to go and do stuff. And making music was making music. It wasn't trying to make money in the music. So I was always just doing music with heart. Mm-hmm. Do you get me?
Did that ever cause big struggles though? I mean, along the way, I mean, it must have been, you know, when you're so authentic and you're not thinking like there's many people in different sort of fields of work who have that same kind of mind state. They're not doing it for the money, they're doing it for the actual art form.
There's
a struggle along the way.
Yeah, there's a struggle, but them struggles to me were not struggles in terms of stopping. This is the struggle that I don't think is possible.
Mm.
People get to a struggle where they stop. This is impossible for me. The struggle was for me, I weren't on radio.
Mm-hmm.
That was the struggle. The struggle was for me, I can't do a set right now. There was never a struggle where I'm saying, well, you know what, man, this ain't working, boom, boom. That's impossible. There's no such struggle as that for me.
And that's why you're here now with this major status. Yeah. We just played Frontline, produced by Biggie D. Shouts to Biggie D. 2003. Now, that is literally the whole song is obviously, I don't even know if you could call it a song. It's a spraying session. It's a shell down.
Yeah.
No chorus, nothing, just bars. And that, there are a lot of bars that people know word for word on that. that have lived for very long. Now, when you look at 2003 EE and you know the struggles that we're kind of just talking about, and 2018 now, present EE, how much of a change would you say there is to the person and the MC?
The change, there isn't much change. You know, the only change is I'm in song mode right now. See, for when I made that tune there, I was just spraying. Right now, when I spray, I'm picking to spray, and I'm picking. But then I wasn't picking. I was just doing what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm kind of thinking a bit more. The person, and look, I'm supposed to be, have more power in me from then, because that was me for fun. That was me for fun, not thinking about, I'm gonna go and make P, I'm gonna be D double. That's what I'd done, and I was willing to just have that in my room and no one ever heard it.
Mm-hmm.
I would never let that go by now. Mm-hmm. So if I could change the times now, there would be a video and it would be sick.
Yeah.
So the times is, the difference is, I let them things go by.
Mm-hmm.
I've let a lot of things go by, mm-hmm. and now nothing can get by.
So the Jackham album is upon us. Do you feel like when you was recording this album, like a lot of people feel pressure with albums as well, like, mm-hmm. and this is your first album, and there's expectation, there's a reputation that you have a legacy, what people expect from you. Did you feel like you needed to get into a different zone to make this album?
I just felt like I needed to be myself. I needed to be myself, and I needed, it's not about anyone else. It's about me and what I'm lacking and what I know is peak. And I know what's peak. I know what's peak, so it's peak. You know what I'm saying? And when I've listened to other people's music, I can see where there's weak spots. And the weak spots are just things I wouldn't do.
Mm-hmm.
That's a weak spot for me.
I mean, you set up your label. Did you have like a lot of input from, you know, your close-knit circle?
In terms of putting stuff in a bag and like, and then saying, right, which stuff are we going to throw away and what are we going to keep?
Mm-hmm.
And then we get the track list for the album and we're happy. Yeah, I've got a little team of close people.
How concise were you with like the tracks that you made? Some people say that they make like 100 tracks and then they pick like 18 that go on the album. Some, like I know Giggs in particular, he will make a specific amount of songs for a project. Like if it's 20 songs, he's making 21, 22 songs max. And that's exactly the project. Now, what's more your sort of technique?
My sort of technique is probably a bit the same as Giggs, but I've come from a place of backlog.
Mm-hmm.
So my backlog has kind of helped me, but that will run out.
Mm-hmm.
You know them ones. Mm-hmm. So I've been making tunes for the past 2-3 years. When I said, right, I'm making Jackham, I made a bag of new ones, but some of my backlogs have been
made
classical dons.
It have to
and
be on there.
They just got to be on there.
Yeah.
And get them out and then move on. So on my next one, I've even got a few hanging about again.
Mm-hmm.
Get them new ones gone and then hope then it's fresh again.
Mm-hmm.
But it's never ever good to be, not have no tunes.
Mm-hmm.
In the
catalog,
you're always
going
to have something hanging about.
Was Jackham the first choice as the album title? Was that just like, it's going to be called Jackham?
That was very hard process.
Oh, for real?
That was a hard process, man. The first ever album, D-Double. Mm-hmm. That was a hard process,
It
man.
Could have been called Oh My Word.
Nah, not even like that. I'm thinking about like, this is like one of the reasons why I got this on my neck. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking about what people call me, who I'm, what I'm like. Like, how, like, when I see Wiley's one, Godfather, like, okay, cool. The God, like for me,
it's not, the association.
I'm not big headed, so I don't want certain things. But I want it to look G, but I'm not big headed, so it's not. Man, I'm saying, oh, the GOAT, call it the GOAT, greatest show. It's not that time.
Yeah.
Maybe 3 albums down and I've marked. Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe. Mm-hmm. Right now, it's the beginning, and it shouldn't be the beginning. That's how I'm thinking of it, like. So I had to come from a place of, like, finally. That's not going to be the name of the album, but this is how I felt. Mm-hmm. So this is how I arched in, like, finally. Good things come, you know, like this. And then I just thought, then I just got into my, the real mode. Jackham, that's me, bro. Jackham, innit? Jackham, when you hear me, it's a Jackham. Mm-hmm. It means, that's what it means to me. I can explain it. Mm-hmm. I've been saying it for 10 years. I hear other people saying it. When I hear people say my sayings on radio, I get a bit scared, bro. I get a bit scared. You know how many MCs I've just heard randomly spraying, yeah, oi, oi, Logan Jackham. And I'm hearing...
That's the impact, that's the influence.
Certain things I'm doing, but that's the impact, is great. But I just feel like right now, guys will just take that. So look, Jackham, that's the name of my album. Yeah, that's me. Like, I like when people use my stuff, and you say, yeah, Jackham, like D-double-E. I love all of that. Mm-hmm. When you're just saying Jackham on its own,
yeah,
for me, it sounds like it's a bit loose.
Mm. Now you've put it in stone, basically.
Have to put my stuff in stone. No one's gonna do it for me.
Oh my word! What an interview with SK Vibemaker and D-double-E.
But back in the day, used to call it. Nowadays, man, them call it there. Back in the day, used to call it a OZ. Nowadays, man, them call it a Z. Back in the day, used to call them boy them. Nowadays, man, them call them fed. Back in the day, used to make a little phone call. Now, man, wanna FaceTime instead. Back in the day, you used to be murky. Now, all your bars are dead. Back in the day, you used to be a leader. Now, that man have to be led. Back in the day, shoot.